Good day. Kindly follow me on my Facebook page and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you. In this video, I will teach you about the systems of linear equation in two variables. First is the consistent system. So we have the given graph, and the blue line here is for the graph of the equation y equals negative x plus 3, and the violet or purple line is for the equation y equals 2x minus 3. So when we said consistent system, it is consistent if the linear equation has exactly one solution. The graph has one point of intersection and formed intersecting or perpendicular lines. So ngayon, pag-usapan muna natin ang consistent system wherein the lines formed an intersecting line. So when we said intersecting line, or if the graph is formed by intersecting lines, the slope of the lines are not equal and the y-intercepts are also not equal. So we can write this into equation m sub 1 is not equal to m sub 2 and b sub 1 is not equal to b sub 2, wherein m is for the slope and b is for the y-intercepts. So kung mapapansin nyo dito, ang dalawang lines ay nag-form ng curve line or hindi siya right angle automatic, that is an intersecting lines. Next is for the second condition for the consistent system. Again, let us consider this given graph. So the blue line is for the equation y equals negative 1/3 x plus 4, and the purple line is for the equation y equals 3x plus 2. So if the line or if the linear equation has exactly one solution, ganun pa rin kapag sinabing consistent, it consists only one solution. The graph has one point of intersection and formed intersecting or perpendicular lines. So ngayon pag-usapan natin ang perpendicular lines. So kapag sinabing perpendicular lines, it form a right angle here. So kapag kinonekta natin ang dalawang points, dalawang lines, nag-intersect sila sa isang point and then they formed a right angle or with the degrees of 90 degrees. So yun yung tinatawag nating perpendicular line. Kapag naman sinabing intersecting line, hindi siya mag-form ng right angle. So for the perpendicular line, the slope of the lines are negative reciprocals of each other. The product of the slope is negative 1 and the y-intercepts are not equal. So kung kanina sa consistent system or one condition ng consistent system, kapag ang lines ay nag-form ng intersecting, the slopes are not equal and the y-intercepts are not equal. Kapag naman nag-form ang lines ng perpendicular line, the slope or the two slopes has the product of negative 1 and the y-intercepts are not equal. Second system is the inconsistent system. Let us consider this given graph. So as you can see, we have the two lines, the blue and the purple. So blue line here is the graph for y equals 2x plus 1, and purple is for the equation y equals 2x minus 3. So when we said inconsistent system, it is inconsistent if the linear equation has no solution. Ibig sabihin, walang values ng x and y. The graph formed parallel lines. So kung mapapansin nyo, ang dalawang line ay hindi nag-intersect sa kahit saang point. So iyon yung tinatawag nating parallel line. Kapag in-extend, ang dalawang lines ay never silang mag-i-intersect or mag-tatagpo. The slope of the lines are equal, but the y-intercepts are not equal. So in equation, this will be m sub 1 is equal to m sub 2, and b sub 1 is not equal to b sub 2. At iyon yung tinatawag nating inconsistent system. The third system is the dependent system. So let us consider this given graph. As you can see, we have two lines, the blue and the purple line. Pero yung line na purple ay nasa line din ng blue. So the equation for the blue line is y equals negative x plus 6. And for the purple line, that is the graph for the equation y equals negative x plus 12. So when we said dependent system, it is dependent if the linear equation has infinite or many solutions or walang katapusan yung solutions niya para sa values ng x and y. The graph formed overlapping or coinciding lines. Na kung saan kapag sinabing overlapping, naka-overlap or nakapatong yung isang line sa isa pang line. The slope of the lines are the same and the y-intercepts are also the same. So for the equation, this will be m sub 1 is equal to m sub 2 and b sub 1 is equal to b sub 2. So kapag tulad ang values ng slope at ng y-intercepts, therefore that is called as the dependent system. Without graphing, determine the graphs of the system of linear equations if parallel, perpendicular, intersecting, or coinciding lines. So kapag walang given na graph, ay malalaman pa rin natin kung ang magiging lines ba ng dalawang equations ay parallel, perpendicular, intersecting, or coinciding by solving for the slope and the y-intercepts. So for example, we have the equations 3x plus y is equal to 9 and 9x plus 3y is equal to 27. So write the equation in slope-intercept form. Kapag sinabing slope-intercept form, iyon yung form natin na y equals mx plus b. So kailangan nating malaman ano yung m at ano yung b or yung slope at y-intercept. So let us write the equation 3x plus y is equal to 9 will be y equals negative 3x plus 9 because we transposed positive 3x to the right side of the equation. So this will now become negative 3x and yung 9 ay positive 9 pa rin dahil nasa right side naman siya ng equation. Next, for the second equation, this will be 3y equals negative 9x plus 27. Pero kung mapapansin nyo, ang pangalawang equation natin ay divisible sa 3. Kayang i-divide ang 3y sa 3, ganun din ang negative 9 at positive 27. So let us simplify first this given or this second equation. Divide it or divide the whole equation into 3. So the answer will be y equals negative 3x plus 9. Because 3 divided by 3 is 1 or y na lang. Negative 9 divided by 3 is negative 3 and 27 divided by 3 is positive 9. Next, meron na tayong slope-intercept form ng dalawang equations na given kanina. So ngayon, alamin na natin ano yung slope at ano yung intercepts ng dalawang equation. So kung mapapansin nyo sa ating first equation, meron tayong positive 9. Sa pangalawang equation ay positive 9 din. And then magkatulad din ang slope nila which is negative 3. Therefore, m is equal to negative 3. And b is equal to 9 for the first equation. And the second equation, m equals negative 3. And b is equal to positive 9. So tulad ang slope at ang y-intercepts. So this will be m sub 1 is equal to m sub 2. And b sub 1 is equal to b sub 2. So kapag tulad or equal ang slope at ang y-intercepts, it formed coinciding lines or overlapping lines. At under sila, ng dependent system. Another example, we have the given equations 2x minus y equals 3 and 5x plus y is equal to 11. Write the equation in slope-intercept form. So magiging negative y equals negative 2x plus 3 and gagawin nating positive yung y by multiplying the whole equation or whole slope-intercept form into negative 1 para mawala yung negative dito. So magiging y equals positive 2x minus 3. So kung mapapansin nyo, nagbago yung sign ng tatlong terms. Next, for the second equation, this will be y equals negative 5x plus 11. Hindi na natin imumultiply ang equation na ito sa negative 1 since positive na yung ating y. So let us now determine the slopes and the y-intercepts. So for the first equation, we have this, the y-intercept negative 3 And for the second equation, that is positive 11. So, magkaiba sila ng y-intercepts. And for the slope, ang first equation natin ay may positive 2 na slope. And then, yung second is negative 5. So, therefore, m is equal to 2 and b is equal to negative 3. M is equal to negative 5 and b is equal to positive 11. Therefore, m sub 1 is not equal to m sub 2 and b sub 1 is not equal to b sub 2. Dahil magkaiba ang 2 sa negative 5, ganun din ang negative 3 sa positive 11. Therefore, ang mapoform na lines when we graph these given equations will be intersecting lines. Because m or the two slopes are not equal and the y-intercepts are not also equal. Next example, we have the given equations x plus 2y equals 10 and x plus 2y is equal to 15. So, we have to write the equation in slope-intercept form. So, this will be 2y equals negative x plus 10 and 2y equals negative x plus 15. Pero kung mapapansin nyo, ang dalawa nating equations na slope-intercept form ay may numerical coefficient na 2 beside the variable y. So, we have to eliminate the numerical coefficient 2 by dividing the whole equation by 2. So, the first equation will be y equals negative 1/2 x plus 5. Because 2 divided by 2 is 1 or simply y. Negative x over 2 or divide by 2 will be negative 1/2 x. Dahil may numerical coefficient na 1 ang x dito, so since hindi kayang i-divide ang 1 sa 2, so magiging fraction siya. And then positive 10 divide by 2 will be positive 5. For the second equation, again, divide the whole equation by 2. So the resulting equation will be y equals negative 1/2 x plus 15 over 2 because we cannot divide or there is no exact whole number when we divide 15 by 2. So, the y-intercept for the first equation will be positive 5. And for the second equation, that will be 15 over 2. And then, kung mapapansin nyo, ang mx natin o yung m natin ay parehong negative 1/2. Therefore, m is equal to negative 1/2 for the first equation and b is equal to 5. For the second equation, m is equal to negative 1/2 and b is equal to 15 over 2. Therefore, m sub 1 is equal to m sub 2 but b sub 1 is not equal to b sub 2. So kapag i-graph natin ang dalawang equation na ito, ang ma-form nilang lines will be parallel lines. So let us now summarize what we have learned in this lesson. First, is the consistent system. When we said consistent system, it is a system if the linear equation has exactly one solution, the graph has one point of intersection and formed intersecting or perpendicular lines, the slope of the lines are not equal, and the y-intercepts are also not equal. When we said inconsistent system, it is inconsistent if the linear equation has no solution, the graph formed parallel lines, the slope of the lines are equal, but the y-intercepts are not equal. And then the last, dependent system, it is dependent if the linear equation have infinite or many solutions, the graph formed overlapping or coinciding lines, the slope of the lines are the same, and the y-intercepts are also the same. So thank you for watching. If you have questions or suggestions, feel free to comment below. Enjoy learning mathematics. God bless us all!